How's it going, everybody? In this video, we are going to talk about micro commitments, what they are and how you can use them to make your marketing far more effective. This is going to help you to increase your conversion rates and get more out of any paid advertising you're doing or any kind of web traffic that you have going to your website or places where you collect information. So it's going to be very helpful for you. If you enjoy this video, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe. If you ever have any questions or comments, please be sure to comment below. My name is Brandon Brashears. I create daily digital marketing videos here. So if you're looking to grow your brand or your business with digital marketing, be sure to subscribe. Again, I do daily videos. So if you want to improve your marketing, be sure to hit that bell button to get notifications every single day. All right, so let's talk about micro commitments. What are micro commitments? I want you to imagine for a second that you are out and you're a single guy or a single girl and you see somebody that's interesting. What would you do typically? Would you go over there and start talking to them and say, hey, how's it going? My name is Brandon, or, you know, small talk, whatever you use to open the conversation and get things started. You wouldn't typically go over to somebody and say, hey, my name's Brandon. It is great to meet you. Could I have your name, phone number, email, and address? I would like to, you know, follow up with you if that's okay. I think you're interesting. That would be super creepy. Why do we do that online then? That's exactly what you're asking for when you meet a stranger. Like somebody comes on your website and you say, hey, how's it going? What are you interested in? Can I get your name, phone number, and email so that I can follow up with you? Because I would really like to follow up with you. That's very, very creepy. So what are some ways that we can use micro commitments? Those little itty bitty steps in between, you know, becoming, having somebody jump on your site and land on your site to eventually becoming a client or a customer. Each one of those small steps is a micro commitment. So when you can get people to take small steps that don't seem as intimidating, it helps you to get better conversion rates. So the first thing that you need to think about when you're thinking about micro conversions and converting strangers into clients is that, number one, you need to break it down into the smallest steps possible. If you're going to send somebody a free guide, or if you're giving somebody a download or something like that on your website, which most people do, asking for just the bare minimums helps you to get more conversion. And again, it's because they don't know you yet. You need to establish trust and provide value so that you can take the next step in that relationship or in that journey. So, you know, asking for first name and email, that's a lot less threatening than first name, email, last name, and phone number. What are the minimum pieces of information that you need to provide that value so that they can then go on to the next step? So, typically, especially if somebody gets a free guide or a free resource, it needs to be something that's actually going to be useful or helpful or provide value so that you can increase the credibility that you have with that client or customer. It also needs to be delivered in a way that they can rapidly consume that and then take the next step. So think about it in terms of tiny steps in getting to that end conversion goal. So if somebody says on your website, for example, they land on your website and then you have a button that says, you know, get a free guide on 3 ways to grow your business. And they say, that sounds interesting. I'd like that. They click the button. Yes, I'm interested. And then another button pops up and it says, so that we can send you your guide, what is your name and email so that we'll be able to send it to you? Then you put in the name and email, and on the confirmation page, they can also download it right away. And on that confirmation page can have an upsell for, you know, we see that you requested these 3 items. We find that it's helpful for a lot of our clients to then go and do a one-on-one consultation. Would you like a free marketing ideas consultation, something that's related, and another small step that's low perceived risk but high perceived value to them? When people opt into things, it's because the value of the thing that they're getting outweighs the risk or the time waste or whatever it is. People typically are nervous, especially today, to, you know, make their attention so fragmented. Inboxes are more crowded than ever, and people are more protective of their inbox, of their subscription feeds, of who's following them and who they're following. So they don't just do it for no reason. People want to have a reason to follow you. And so each one of those micro steps that you use to take people from being a stranger to a customer, it needs to have a specific purpose. It needs to provide a specific value. So establishing each one of those steps is called the customer value journey. What can you do to take somebody from being a stranger into a client or a customer. So think about what are their biggest pain points, what are their biggest problems, what are the biggest issues that they're facing, and break it down into small logical steps that have low perceived risk and high perceived gain. If you can do that and create a system that drives traffic to those pages and people through that process, you're going to be able to consistently and systematically drive customers into your business. I hope this makes sense. If you have any questions, comments, or need help with anything, please don't hesitate to reach out. If you like this video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button, and please let me know if you have any questions or comments down in the comment section below. Hope you have a fantastic day, and see you on the next video.